Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here today. I want to talk to us about taking up our cross and following Jesus. I'll be reading out of the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 38, King James Version. And it says, "He that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me." So a cross, and people have all types of explanations of what that cross is. Now, one thing I want to make mention of, he that taketh not his cross, that everybody's got a cross. But if you go into the immediate context of Matthew chapter 10, let's look at what he's trying to say the cross is. This is the words of the Creator God, Jesus Christ. So we'll back up to verse 33. Let's do that. It says, "But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. For I am come to set a man at variance against his father." This is verse 35 of Matthew 10, and it's in the context of taking up a cross. "And the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's foes shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me." So, in that context, while I realize that in verse 38, the cross could be many other things, one of the things it was trying to say is sometimes it's in our own household, it's our own family, trying to get us not to live for Jesus Christ. You know, there's very few ties on earth stronger than family ties. And it is so difficult to fight for truth against family. I have seen so often in my years, 32 years of ministry, that family keeps people away from the truth. So often, some people say, well, we'll do part of the truth. We'll do some of the truth. We'll live a little bit the way God wants us to, but not all the way. And threats of divorce. I've pastored wives that were beaten unmercifully by their husbands because they wouldn't give up the truth and they wouldn't give up what Jesus did at the cross. So sometimes our cross is even our family. And it says we've got to love Jesus even more than our family. Now, think about that. You have to love Jesus more. But also, if you love your family, you'll love Jesus more. You're not loving anybody if you give in to your family, and the only hope of salvation and the only light they've got, the love of God and the truth of Scripture, is then snuffed out by your compromise. So while God does want families to come to Him together, look at the Philippian jailer. There's many instances in the New Testament of entire families, Cornelius' household coming to God, Lydia's household coming to God, and that is the will of God. But occasionally when family comes against you, you've got to show you love your Heavenly Father more than you love anything else. And that is a cross. God bless you. Keep living for Jesus. It's the best way, even if that's your cross today. Talk with you later in Jesus. Amen.